I just got the Revopoint Pop 2 scanner. We're going to compare that scanner to the 3D Makerpro Whale handheld scanner and do a little shootout.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making.
Alfred backpack hanger in stainless steel and aluminum, designed by me, holds your backpack, lets you charge your phone, holds your keys, super versatile. So I'm packing up some here that were recently sold. Thanks for those of you who've purchased recently. It really helps support the channel.
This video is sponsored by my longtime sponsor, PCBway. So once you've scanned in your objects and you've built them in CAD, check out PCBway. They have a host of 3D printing options, including SLA, DLP, FTM, SLM, SLS, or even vacuum casting. PCBway can help you on your next 3D printing project. Link below. The Whale from 3D Maker Pro comes packed nice, just like the Revopoint scanner does, in a cardboard box, and you get this kick-ass case that comes with it.
Oh yeah, baby.
Look at that.
That's a case. That's a piece of gear. That needs a sticker right there.
Before I even open it, that gets a sticker. That gets a design and making sticker, like instantly. That 100%
meets with my approval.
So far, so good. All right, let's check out the Whale. I mean, this is a waterproof case. Ooh, look at that. So it looks like power supply, USB. Ooh, USB and micro USB. That makes me not excited. This is probably the turntable. Micro USB. That's disappointing. Why not USB-C? Tripod. Oh, look at that. Nice video adapter. Oh, it's got little teeth on it, actually. Look at that. Sturdy aluminum tripod with teeth, locks in. That's nice. Ooh, look at that fancy cable. Power. Probably connection to the thing and USB right here.
Old school USB, by the way, so that makes me not happy. I mean, that's just piss poor. It's 2022 and you're using old school USB connectors.
That's horrible. This is some sort of a cylinder. Don't know exactly. Well, maybe this is an extension. Who knows? Just for handhold. And here we got the unit itself.
The Whale.
Scanner, yep, there's power goes in there. Nice. So that's nice industrial design on there. Somebody spent some time doing that. Very nice, very fine. Jeez. That's questionable. Let's unbox the Revopoint Pop 2 scanner. Comes nicely packaged here. Pull it out. So this is the premium, I think, because it includes the turntable. And it comes in a nice case here as well. Let's take it out and check out what's inside of it. This is the turntable. And it pops together. It's just cheap old plastic. Nothing amazing. I believe this is the handheld unit for the mobile scanning, so that you can use your phone. And then this is the turntable. It all comes packed in some foam. Nothing amazing, but it does have battery capabilities. Yep. And it uses a micro USB-C, so a huge turnoff for me. You know, it's 2022 and you're using micro USB, shame on you. This is the tripod for the unit. It's mainly plastic. It works. It's, you know, average. And then this is the scanner right here itself. This is the Pop 2. It's solid construction. It's made out of metal. Looks very similar to the original Pop scanner, and it uses this old school USB connection. So shame on you again for not using USB-C. Just terrible.
Okay, so the first scanner we're gonna use is the Revopoint 2, and we're gonna scan this object, which is the same object that I've scanned in the past with the scanners. And this is a vehicle shape that's been primed in gray and has some speckles on it and makes it easy to scan. So we'll see how the Revopoint 2 performs with this object that we've scanned in the past. I'll put this plate, this comes with the kit, on here. It'd be nice if you could actually center this. It just slides around, kind of garbagey. It's pretty chintzy, as you know, the way it is, but it'd be nice if you could lock it into the middle so it actually rotated, you know, circularly. That would make placing whatever object that you have on top of here actually rotate in the middle of the object. Seems obvious, but apparently not.
Let's scan it on the turntable, and it seems to be scanning pretty decent. And we'll flip it over to see if we can scan the bottom. So it can't line up. It doesn't seem to work that way. I don't know. The videos online show this. I'm not able to get that to work. So I'm not sure what sort of magic is involved to make that happen. So this is the scan data that I get when it's pulled into Fusion 360. Looks decent. It has little bumps on it, some textures or whatever, but if this is your reference model, should be fine. It's picking up some of the subtle details in the model. Standard for RevoPoint, this is what you're gonna get.
Since this stuff comes with USB-A plugs, stupid, I have to use my own adapters to get power for the camera and an adapter to get power for the turntable. Dumb.
I had a lot of trouble with the software for this Whale on the Mac. I tried to use it with a Intel laptop, even talked to the developers, and they were not astute enough to ask me what sort of a processor I had in my computer. So I switched to my Mac Studio, which is Apple silicone, and the software worked instantly. It's caused huge setbacks. So if you have an Intel Mac, forget it. At least currently, you need Apple silicone for this to work. I use the Whale scanner to scan the little vehicle shape here. And you can see on the left, the screen image, it shows you how far away you are from the object, and it helps you guide you to get the correct distance for the proper scan. It's scanned without any issue. First time here. No problem. Let's compare the data directly side by side here. So this is the Revopoint Pop 2 scanner, which you saw before. Looks okay. And then this is the Whale scanner, actually. So a lot cleaner mesh as well with the Whale scanner compared to the Revopoint. Let's throw some shade on there. You get a texture here as well. I suspect this is from the speckles on the paint job on this thing to help it scan. So as scanners are getting better, probably need that less and less.
The thing that I really want to scan is this rock rooster shoe. They're really nice shoes, by the way. And you can follow the link in the description to get your own discount as well.
When we scan the shoe with the Revopoint, there's a special dark mode that you can select for dark objects. And it has a tough time. I'll be honest here. It can sort of make some scans, but it has a tough time with the fact that the shoe is basically not as symmetrical or squarish kind of object, right? It's rectangular, so sometimes it's closer and farther away when it's on the turntable, so it has a tough time in addition to the fact that it's a dark object. So to scan this with the RevoPoint, you'd probably have to paint it with some paint or something, dust it with something light, some sort of light powder. But I really was not able to get any sort of a satisfactory sort of a scan from the RevoPoint on this dark object. We use the whale scanner to scan the rock rooster piece of footwear here, and it does a much, much better job of scanning this dark piece of footwear. I have it raised on a paint can here, and I'm able to get a lot more of the 360. You can see it kind of pause sometimes when it loses its tracking, but it's able to go back and pick up the tracking in a way that's far superior to the RevoPoint, actually. This is the data that I get in Fusion here. It's very nice. You can really see the details almost down to the stitching, and you can certainly see the details of the texture. So this is in the raw data. I'm personally not so interested in the texture mapping, but it's pretty good as well.
I wish there was something I could just hold in my hand and see what I was scanning while I was holding it in my hand. The whale is kind of like drawing on a tablet with no screen. Maybe an iPad. Sort of like could work and scan with this. Let's try a photogrammetry app on the iPad.
I'm going to be using the 3D scanner app. This is available in the App Store for iOS and macOS. It's free and has pretty good rating. So we'll try it out. I also get good recommendations from my friend about this. So I'm willing to give it a try, and we'll see as a sort of point and shoot device. My whole thing about 3D scanning is that it should be point and shoot. You know, all this other stuff of software and everything, forget it. It should be like driving a car. Push the button, press the pedal, go. Or, you know, that's not even going to be a thing in the future. Push the button and it just drives you to where you want to go. That's how you want technology to work for you. You don't want to have to jump through hoops and all this rigmarole bullshit of software that doesn't work, stitching shit together, cleaning stuff up. You don't want that. So I'm pretty impressed here. If you're looking for good texture mapping, this photogrammetry thing works really well. I mean, look at this shoe. So if you're doing asset creation and you're just looking for these really nice texture maps, I think photogrammetry in this case is really the way to go, more so than the scanners. The data that you get is, you know, piss poor, in my opinion. That's garbage. You can't use that. Compare this to the whale scanner here, which is much, much more detailed, much more precise. So you gotta use the right tool for the right job. So let's try to scan the Gator IFV. If you don't know this vehicle, it's something I did a huge series on previously, designing it, building a wireframe, and then ultimately making a foam core model. So just licensed this to somebody, and I needed a scan to send to them so that they could build it in the computer. And this seemed like a perfect opportunity for this. And we use the whale to scan this in. It loses tracking, but it's able to pick up and pull the pieces together. And this is the scan that I get. I think this is my third try. So pretty straightforward, really nice data that you get. It has trouble with the black wheels. In this case, but all the other surfaces, no problem, really nice. And it's all triangles, so rebuilding this in the computer should be pretty straightforward. I use the exact same setup for the RevoPoint, and it couldn't do it. It would lose tracking continuously. It just didn't work. At least, you know, in my quick, feeble attempt, and it should be easy, and it's not. Now this is the scan from the 3D scanner app, and it's okay. Again, if you're looking for texture map sort of solution on the go, quickly on the fly, this isn't too bad here. Gives you a good sense of the surfaces and what it looks like, you can see there's some webbing and some weird shit in there, but that's what you get. The data, again, on the 3D scanner app, photogrammetry, is just garbage, but the texture mapping is nice. So here's the data pulled into Fusion 360 of the Gator infantry fighting vehicle. Really nice data. I'm very pleased with how the whale performed, its learning curve, and the final data that you get. So this would be, in my opinion, pretty good data. I think my overall takeaway from this project is that use the right tool for the right job. Some experimenting may be required, but depending upon what it is that you actually need is going to determine what scanner that you want to use for whatever project that you're working on. Do your research, watch other YouTube videos, and get the right tool for the right job. Photogrammetry is getting better. It's not as idiot-proof as it should be, or point-and-click as it should be, in my opinion, but we're getting there.
Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Make sure to hit the bell so you get notifications every time I have a new video. Also, don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Links in the description below and on the channel page. Rock on. Don't forget to check out the t-shirts and hoodies in the merch shelf below. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.